This is big breaking emergency news. We are now seeing top commanders and Pentagon officials, the head of NORTHCOM and NORAD is now coming out and he is warning that we are under attack inside the United States. We are having incursions daily. He is warning that there's an invasion from the land and from the sky and from the sea going on right now. And he's extremely worried about incursions from the air into the United States. The Pentagon is warning of that we are being swarmed with foreign aircraft into our airspace constantly, bombarded, right? And he is also warning that there is an invasion going on, and he is extremely worried about foreign nationals from certain countries entering into our country and forming military units and foreign spies slipping through the cracks, right? So this is very serious. This is a urgent warning, and he is warning that these drones could be used for attacks on the US, and they are attacking the US constantly and bombarding us. So let's dive into this news here. This is a urgent emergency alert. The Pentagon is worried that something big is gonna happen, and it's related to our open border and our open skies. Everything's wide open. The country is wide open, and NORTHCOM, NORAD, everyone is worried. Everyone doesn't know what's going on, and they are now investigating to see what are we supposed to do in this situation when the border and the skies and the sea are now wide open. All right, so please hit it up for me down there. Hit that like, hit that subscribe button. I'm posting multiple times a day, keeping you guys updated on this big emergency news. All right, so let's dive into this here. You can see here, this is what top US general is now warning of, okay? He is the commander of NORTHCOM and NORAD. This is General Gregory M. Gillett, right? And he is extremely worried about two major things. He is worried about drone incursions at our border and at US military bases are being targeted as well, their airspace. And he's also worried about Chinese nationals attempting to cross our southern border, right? So very serious. He's worried that there's an invasion going on of Chinese nationals. So let's get into this quote here from him really quick. He is talking about drones that are entering our country as well. He's worried about both of these things. There's an invasion from the air and from the land and from the sea as well happening in places like Florida now too, and even California. There are boats just showing up on the shores every single day. So I want you to listen to what this top Pentagon commander just warned of about our US southern border and about the invasion going on as well. We're going to read some quotes of some things he warned of as well. But listen to
I don't
this.
know the actual number. I don't think anybody does, but it's in the thousands. I have talked to Customs and Border Protection, who are responsible for the UAS incursions and in the border, along with DOJ, and they put the number at thousands.
Over what period of time is that, thousands?
I would say in the probably over a month. We could
Wow.
probably have over 1,000 a month.
General, do they, in your view, represent a homeland defense threat?
Senator, they alarm me from being the person responsible for homeland defense. I haven't seen any of them manifest in a threat to the level of national defense, but I see the potential only growing.
All right, so you heard that there. That was General Gillott, right? And he is warning that our skies are wide open. And he's extremely worried that something's going to be brought over and some kind of attack is going to happen with these drones. He's also worried about the number of Chinese that are coming across our US southern border as well. He was asked about it, and this is what he said. He said, quote, "The number of Chinese that are coming across the border is a big concern of mine. In fact, in the short period of time that I've been in command, I've gone down to the southern border to talk to agents and leadership about that. And I've also spoken with the acting commissioner of the CBP on this subject. He said, what concerns me the most about specifically the Chinese migrants is, one, that they're so centralized in one location on the border, and two, is while many may be political refugees, other explanations, the ability for counterintelligence to hide in plain sight is in those numbers, right? So he's saying that they could be sending counterintelligence officials, military officials, spies, all these things are on the table, and they could potentially be sent into our country, hiding in plain sight, right? So this isn't made up. This isn't just like, oh, you guys are worried about this for no reason. The Pentagon is worried. The military is worried. He knows that he is responsible for this. And he knows that if anything happens, we're going to be looking at him. And we're going to be looking at our leaders. And they haven't stopped this threat. And he's extremely worried about it and concerned about it. And he doesn't control the Border Patrol, right? And the National Guard. So there's really nothing he can do when it comes to the situation, but this needs to end. This needs to stop, and hopefully more military leaders come out and say that this is a national security threat, so something changes at our border. And he is worried about a lot of crossings in one location. The main location crossing for Chinese crossings has been in the San Diego sector and in California, right? That's where most of the crossings have been. And he's probably most concerned about that as well, because if there ever was some kind of attack or invasion from China, not saying there's going to be, but if there ever was, it would come from the West Coast, most likely. Makes sense. And that's where a lot of the entrances are. And these numbers are crazy. Just last year, 2 years ago, it was 3,000-4,000 people crossing, right? In the entire year. In the entire year. Now, just this year alone, we've seen around 40,000 people come from China. Just this year. Just in a few months, right? So this is very serious. This is a major increase. And it's always been a few thousand a year here and there. All right, the numbers have always been very low, but all of a sudden we're seeing 10,000 plus a month. All right, these are very serious numbers and very big numbers. And there could definitely be people slipping through the cracks. All right, so you need to be getting prepared. You need to be getting ready, right? They could do anything. They have these balloons that are flying over the country all the time. NORAD was activated for one of these balloons a couple weeks ago, all right, that was flying over Colorado, Utah, and then there was another balloon outside of Alaska, all right, that was trying to enter the country as well. All these things, our airspace is wide open, and he's worried these drones, they could be used anywhere, and he's worried that they are bringing potentially hazardous things over the border with these drones as well, and nobody's even detecting it or catching it at all. And then these things could be released inside the U.S., whether it's radiological, biological, nuclear, any type of event, chemical. It could be any one of these things that are released from a drone over a major city. Imagine a biological weapon released over a city, major U.S. city. Right? No one would even know. Drone is gone. It's in and out of everyone's sight. No one would even know. Right? This is what's going on. And we are even seeing this incursion on our U.S. military bases as well. There was a major drone swarm of our U.S. military base in December in Virginia. This was around Langley Air Force Base in Virginia, and they didn't know why all these drones were swarming this Air Force base, and they even went as far as to have NASA out there, and they had their special NASA airplanes that have this very sensitive monitoring equipment, right? And they were flying in circles around the airbase and trying to get imaging of this entire area, mapping it out and get very accurate imaging of this region, because there were constant bombardments of drones over this military base, right? They were constantly entering their airspace and around it, and they didn't know where they were coming from or what they were doing. So they had to get this NASA imaging plane out to map out the area and to really see exactly where these drones are coming from, right? So very serious, and they are so quiet. They don't show up on a lot of normal radar. The drones don't. They're so quiet and small, and they move at very slow speeds. They can just stop moving at any point. So they're undetectable to a lot of different radar systems and detection systems. They're able to get around them very easily. A lot of drones are. And they could even be used to attack our military bases as well. And they essentially were. They're essentially doing dry runs, swarming our bases with these drones domestically inside the U.S. to see how we're going to respond. Who's operating these drones? Who's flying these drones? How do we not know who's flying them? Where are these drones coming from? Everything. Because domestic drones are all registered. They know where they're coming from. People that buy them inside the U.S., they're tracking them. They have these things that can shut them down. They can shut down the drones instantly. The FAA can in the military. But for some reason, they weren't able to shut down these drones. All right, so something's going on. Where are they coming from? Who's funding them? Who's operating them? It could be foreign militaries that are doing dry runs inside of our country, right, to take out critical infrastructure. And they were even warning that these drones in this report, because they just released this happened in December, the swarm, and there's still been incursions, but there hasn't been the bombardment that they saw in December at this military base. But they are worried as well that these drones could be used to target critical infrastructure inside the U.S., and they could just kamikaze them into the power grid, into a nuclear power plant, anything. Or they could have explosives on them. All these things are there, and the military is extremely worried about it, right? And if you remember that Border Patrol helicopter that suspiciously crashed last week, right? There were multiple National Guard members that lost their life. Very tragic situation. This was a federalized National Guard unit flying on the border, and they had this very strange crash. And there was a cartel drone that was watching the crash, and they were laughing and saying very disturbing things about the crash, sick things about it, right? And they had a drone watching it already, and they recorded it and posted on social media, and they were laughing about it, right? I covered this when it happened, and a drone could have been flown into this helicopter, and they are just not telling everyone. They're saying there's thousands of drones crossing the border every single month, and they're worried about it. So make sure you're getting prepared. Make sure you're getting ready, right? Get stocked up. We could see big hits to critical infrastructure, and that's what they're worried about. And they're worried about our open border being exploited as well. So get stocked up, get ready, get prepared now, right? Get your prepper pantry filled up. Let me give you guys a quick update, right? On some chicks here. These chicks will be outside soon. Right, you hear squealing here. We actually have another chick over here that has a little bumble foot on her foot. So we're going to have to do some work on her to get that foot. It's like a big bubble on her foot. And we're going to have to get that cleared up for her, worked on for her. She's had this problem with her foot the whole time. Not this chick. There's a different chick over here. And that's something that we're going to have to fix up for her soon. Right, so get yourself ready, get your homestead ready, get your prepper pantry ready, get going, guys. We got chicks outside laying already. We're getting our garden going, all this stuff. We're working hard, and you need to be too. 2024 is going to be a big year, right? So thank you, guys. I hope you have big blessings for your life, your family, and I hope you have a big old blessed day.